first connection with music must have been like what my grandma would play or what my parents were playing around the house. When I left secondary school, a lot of it was like 90s hip hop sort of stuff, like Tribe Quest. That's what really got me into music.
Got something to show you. Yeah, this isn't actually out yet, but obviously by the time this comes out, it'll probably be out. But Who Sold My Soul?
When I started making music, I came to AudioActive and it kind of just like accentuated that, and like I met Tom Hines and Chemistry and everything sort of like connected up basically.
Just having a space in the community to come and make music and to meet people is essential. It's just a real melting pot of stuff that's going on and a real crossover of generational artists that get to kind of work with each other and meet each other.
Beginning with no end, lost my brain and now it's harder to attend. Now I'm sitting on the fence and my first ain't fucking quenched. This ain't making any sense, but I guess it never did. I'm too quick off the mark and to start, it's the past that I need to try to forget. And I ain't never been upset, it's just thoughts inside my head that I'm trying to recollect. It's a mess, it's like the truth becoming harder to confess. It's like body will object, it's like too many times I could see how it could go, and it always seems to do that, right? I say too many different times, oh I could see how it could go, and it always seems to do that. Say lost within my own thoughts, moving too quick, I know I won't pause. Yeah, you learn to strike a nerve, and I don't even care if it's on purpose. I can tell you lack a purpose. Indigo light seems to flicker in the rain with no rainbows. Rain, sunshine, and the hailstones. This weather has become like my emotions. Unstable as this weather is, don't know what my destination is. Thinking it's the right way, but always took the wrong route. I say too many times, I could see how it could go, and it always seems to do that.
I remember meeting Derek for the first time just around the corner in the studio just there. I was playing guitar, and Ned in the band was doing bass, and then Derek was just rapping. He must have been 15, 16, I'm not quite sure. It was quite a few years ago, and then fast forward to 2021 and he's, you know, doing really well in his own career.
Wow, that is nice. That is fucking different, isn't it? Working with Derek has made me understand who I am as an artist. I was always focused on just making, but not why I'm making, and I think Derek always knew why he wanted to do something he wanted to do when he does it. And it sounds cheesy, but he taught me to believe in myself and my artistry.
I think the Brighton scene is special because it's very dynamic, always in flux and always in motion. And I think that's a very beautiful and very important thing.
It's a very accepting place and it gives you room to be experimental. You don't have to follow a blueprint. There's no right or wrong way. Nobody's, you know, breathing down your neck and saying, no, you can't do that. You've got an open studio, make whatever the fuck you like.
If I need horns and a song, I just go and knock on that door, I go down the corridor, find this person, that person, and everyone just ends up chilling and collaborating. And then obviously when you add the youth work and like the youngers coming through into that, it's just a sick thing. It just creates a proper community vibe. And when you have like a hub for somewhere, then that creates a scene.
I remember I was talking to my tutor about how I wanted to be part of something. There was this artist development program going on at AudioActive, which is like a young people's music organization. And I won third place on the course, which introduced me to loads of people. By going to the women's sessions at AudioActive, I met Cate and Bobbie, who really influenced me as an artist, and they really helped me find my sound and the kind of courage to get up on stage and make the music I wanted to make. I definitely went to ambient, chilled out, trip hop. I understood that type of music and the music understood me.
It was really sick kind of seeing and hearing her kind of music progress and grow over the time from kind of just little ideas into like full songs, and it was so sick collaborating with her.
For Casper, having a community of women around her that could support her gave her a lot of confidence to be able to explore and perform in the way that she wanted to and be really inventive with that, which is what she does.
Mother, my brother, you will never find another love. days to save us. Telling me your bedtime stories when you call me. Think I'm addicted to your mind, cause you never could call me. Though it's getting late, my dear. When you ever gonna like me back? Is it something by the way I check? Cause I know you're never ever gonna like me. This brown eyed girl, just show me the way inside your world. I won't hesitate to say those words. We all make mistakes to save us.
Describe what's going on in Brighton as like just a really nice epicenter of a collaboration of various musical organizations, of labels, a music charity, and then many sort of individual producers and singer-songwriters and rappers of all ages.
It's not always down to who has the most money, do you know what I mean? Or like who controls or has influence. Like community is like important and powerful, basically.
Influences the music that I make through meeting new people. Everyone is individual in their own way.